profit within this business. And you may find that if you are not providing good enough consumer experience because you're not making a lot of money, you don't have the money to invest in this, it's kind of becoming a vicious circle that it's hard for you to make a business.
Yeah, but I mean, at the same time too, how much competition do you have? You don't have to have the best consumer experience. If you're the only hairdresser in the area.
That's true, but if you're using the internet salon kind of service, you're competing with a BAT.
My business.
BAT being Baidu, Alibaba, right. And Tencent, tech conglomerates here in China. Yes, I think these days for any internet business to want to thrive, and you're competing with those big titans in the industry, as we've listed earlier on, I just feel it's very, very, it's difficult because they have the money, the resources, and I think these days it's often a startup comes up with a brilliant idea and maybe has attracted a certain amount of business and then they get bought up.
Yeah, you know, I think for things like a hair salon to be able to do this, like a hairdresser to come to your house, I think also, you know, there's things people like to just go and do, all right? So I think a lot of, you know, having someone drop something off at your place is one thing where I think e-commerce really shines. But I also would say some of the problems this will have is, like, not everybody wants to welcome a stranger into their home to have them even do a service.